What is up, IF Warriors? So this brand new study that just came out November 21st, 2021, run by Kevin Hall, on looking at the Biggest Loser, re-evaluating that Biggest Loser study that he actually ran back in the day, back in 2016, is changing what we know about weight loss. Let's go ahead and break it down in this video. Stay tuned. Now, Kevin Hall is a senior investigator at the National Institute of Diabetes and Kidney Disease. And he's huge in the metabolic understanding space. He's done studies with the keto diet, with metabolic ward studies where they're in a metabolic ward for a month, and then he re-upped that study and had them there for 2 months, showing keto versus normal dieting, or keto versus non-keto dieting, and the differences between those two things. But he's also notorious for the Biggest Loser study. Now, we understand that the Biggest Loser study was incredibly polarizing. Until this day, Kevin Hall is perplexed by the findings. 13 people that underwent gastric bypass was compared to 13 contestants of The Biggest Loser almost a decade later. And what they saw was that the people that lost weight in The Biggest Loser, their metabolic rate reduced. And when he went back to see if they had regained weight, because as you know, this is a very popular study, he went and checked the data to see what happened to these 13 finalists from The Biggest Loser. And he saw that they had regained weight, which was very concerning. And it just showed, hey, maybe they didn't stick to what they were doing. But when he saw that they had regained weight, he also saw that their metabolic rate was still suppressed. Now, one thing that we do know about metabolic adaptation is that when you lose weight, your metabolism goes down. That just automatically happens because your body is compensating for the weight loss. It's not a streamlined effect where if you just reduce calories, it automatically just goes in a single shot straight down towards weight loss. No, it does not happen like that. What happens is your body adapts, metabolic adaptation. So it adapts because your body is smarter than to just allow you to get to the point where you have 0% body fat and you starve to death. Your body is more complex and more intelligent than that. What it does is it reduces energy output for certain things that it can reduce energy output for. So it becomes more efficient, therefore it burns less calorie at rest. But what was known about this was that if you gain the weight, then your metabolism naturally will also go back up as well, your resting metabolic rate. But it was still suppressed in the contestants from The Biggest Loser, and that, till this day, has perplexed Kevin D. Hall, a world-renowned researcher and investigator when it comes to metabolism. Now, he did a follow-up study because this is just has been getting on his nerves, essentially, because it is not necessarily breaking the laws of thermodynamics, because that is not what's happening. Something is happening hormonally that's suppressing the normal patterns that one would have when losing weight and having metabolic adaptation and gaining weight and having that metabolism go up with them. Something is disrupting that pattern. Therefore, they are burning less calories. Therefore, so basically, calories in versus calories out is still applied. It's just that they are burning less calories due to the hormones. He goes back and tries to understand what is happening. He cannot let this study go because it's just driving him nuts. That's why in November 21, a further look into it was done. Now, what piqued Kevin Hall's interest is a 2012 study looking at Tanzanian tribes who are still hunter and gatherers, and how their metabolism is just like ours. It's just like everyone else's. It doesn't go down, even though they're constantly active, constantly hunting, constantly gathering. And many researchers have hypothesized or theorized that their bodies have compensated in other ways to ensure that they can control their metabolism and keep it at a steady rate. For example, they state that their growth is stunted, because a lot of people from the Tanzanian culture do not grow. They tend to be short. So they're theorizing that the body in other ways have decided to just not even, for example, have them grow taller, because it rather just use the energy more efficiently and with more stability just for them to hunt and gather. This is called the constrained total energy expenditure theory. Now, how does this apply to the biggest loser? Well, because it goes both ways. The same way the Tanzanian culture can just have their metabolic rate stay steady for a particular thing, someone who loses massive weight loss in a rapid pace can also have constrained total energy expenditure because of how daunting it was for them to lose massive weight. Now, this is not for anyone who is losing weight and they're just 20% body fat, 30% body. This is for morbidly obese, really heavy people that lose a lot of weight super fast, like they did in the Biggest Loser show. The whole point of the show was to lose weight super quickly. And here's the kicker. When he went back to see them back in 2016, when he went to see what was going on, why was the Biggest Loser contestants having this issue and regaining weight, he noticed that most of them still continued to do physical activity. They still continue to do physical activity, and that tied in to the suppression of their metabolism. But they were overeating while still doing physical activity, and they weren't doing super strenuous physical activity, but they were doing physical activity, which led to the overall reduction in metabolic rate within the 13 people. So basically, and this is insane, their physical activity is both helping them lose weight and also keeping them from lowering their metabolic rate, essentially almost canceling each other out. Now, this is insane. This is throwing everything for a loop. What do we get from this, though? Number one, please try your best to not gain massive amounts of weight. If you're overweight, that's one thing. If you're morbidly obese, you're going into a realm where there may be some sort of a point of no return where things will always be difficult. Now, it's not that you won't lose weight. You can, but things will always be difficult for you because you may have a suppressed metabolic rate that just won't budge because it's doing a double-edged sword where, yeah, you need to burn the calories, so you have to do physical activity, but the physical activity is also clashing with your metabolism going back to a steady rate, regardless of how much weight you gain. So if you lose weight, if you were to lose massive amounts of weight, you would have to literally work super hard to keep it off. You would have to work very, very hard to make sure you don't gain it back, or you can gradually and slowly lose the weight and not have a drastic moment. So your metabolism slowly goes down, and then it has a better potential to go slowly back up. Also, some of the contestants did manage to keep their weight off. And most of them, even though they regained their weight, they did not regain all of their weight. So the physical activity still helped them, but there is something to be said for the fact that their metabolism was suppressed. And for the people that he said did lose weight, he feels that physical activity helped them in a way where it suppressed appetite, and that kept them from overeating, because even though they were doing the physical activity, a lot of them were still overeating. Now, I want to touch on the final sentence in Kevin D. Hall's abstract, because Kevin D. Hall is huge for being a straight shooter when it comes to calories in versus calories out. And I agree with the stuff that he's stating. I mean, he does metabolic ward studies. Very hard to go against something as rigorous as a metabolic ward study, where you're literally in a metabolic chamber and they're looking at the total daily energy expenditure every single day while you're there. But the thing that I've always pushed for is your hormones in balance, or the hormonal effects that come with the complexity of what it is to be a human trying to lose weight, trying to build muscle, trying to shift things physically in your body, has the same level of importance, if not more, than just focusing on calories in versus calories out. Because although calories in versus calories out is true, and it is what it is, the calories out portion becomes massively complex because our bodies are massively complex. And I want to touch on this final sentence from his abstract from this study that he did November 21st, 2021. Kevin Hall stated, additional longitudinal studies quantifying the interrelationships between various components of energy expenditure and energy intake are needed to better understand the dynamics of human body weight regulation. And that, my friends, says it all. Calories in versus calories out matters, but it may not matter more than the hormonal effects that take place, because that's the true indicator of how much weight you are going to gain and how much weight you are going to lose. Hopefully this video has helped you guys. Patrons will be pinned in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.